Want to make your stories more adaptable, giving users the ability to tailor how information appears in data visualizations? You can leverage scripting in SAP Analytics Cloud to filter visualizations like tables and charts based on the current selection of checkbox options. In the previous video, you programmatically loaded a checkbox group with measures from a model and wrote logic for deselecting and selecting all the values in the checkbox group. In this video, you'll learn how to implement the logic for making sure that the values selected in the checkbox group are reflected in the table and chart in your story. To begin, you'll need to create a script object. In SAP Analytics Cloud, script objects are containers for script functions. After creating the script object, you can give it a meaningful name. When you create a new script object, a script function is automatically created within it. Script functions can be reused throughout the story, helping you to avoid writing the same code multiple times. This makes your code easier to read and maintain. You can name the script function setMeasureFilter. The setMeasureFilter script function needs to accept an array that contains the measures that are currently selected in the checkbox group. You can include an argument called selectedIDs for this purpose. The argument needs to have a type of string and must be an array. Now that you have a script function that accepts the IDs of the selected measures as a parameter, you can begin writing the logic for the function. To filter the dimensions on the table and chart in this story, you can use the method setDimensionFilter. In the API Optimize Story Reference Guide, you'll see that the setDimensionFilter method accepts two parameters. The first is the dimension, and the second is a list of members to be excluded or included in the filter. Before using the setDimensionFilter method, you must identify the name of the dimension to be filtered. Renaming the dimension opens a dialog that displays the name of the dimension you're planning to filter. In this case, the name is Custom Dimension 1. Now that you know the name of the dimension, you can use the setFilterDimension function on the data source of the table. Provide the name of the dimension as the first parameter. For the second parameter, provide the array selectedIDs. You can follow the same process for the chart. Once you've written the logic for the setMeasureFilter script function, you can reuse it in other widgets in the story. For example, you can select the Remove All button and apply the logic to its onClick event by accessing the Utils script object and calling the setMeasureFilter function inside it. First, you call the Utils script object and call the setMeasureFilter inside this object. Since there are no measures selected, you can pass an empty array inside the function as a parameter. Now you apply the same logic to the onClick event of the Select All button, but instead of providing an empty array as a parameter, you can pass the script variable allMeasures. Next, you can update the measures of the selected data visualization whenever a measure in the checkbox group is selected or deselected by applying the script to the widget's onSelect event. You can once again use the setMeasureFilter script function. For this step, you can supply an array of the IDs of the selected dimensions by calling the getSelectedKeys function on the checkbox group widget. Now you can save your changes and test out the functionality in view mode. You'll see that selecting the Remove All button results in all the measures being removed from the table and the chart, and clicking the Select All button populates the table and chart with all the measures. Selecting individual options from the checkbox group results in the chart and table being updated to have only dimensions corresponding to the selected measures. In the next video in the series, you'll learn how to write a script to trigger a pop-up that will allow the user to select which products they would like to see in the table and the chart. To learn more about using a checkbox group to filter the dimensions of tables and charts, check out the help topic links in the description and try it for yourself today.